Mysterious underground creatures are coming towards us.
Silver lining, things can live down here.
Someone hit the lights?
Well, I'll be honest, I'm a little disappointed.
Young people from the Overland, you shall be our leaders!
No, no, we have a leader, it's Dave.
Sup?
It's a democratic hierarchical society.
Wait a minute, who are you guys?
We live below. They call us the Balonies.
No, they don't, Scott. We voted on this. Balonies sounds like a lunch meat. We're called the Undergrounders.
I am the wise healer among my peoples.
He's a pipe fitter.
Where are we?
We call our world Subterranus. Terranus, Terranus.
That one's true. He just wanted it so badly.
I wore them down.
So, where are you kids headed?
Class trip to the museum. I helped organize it.
He shall be our leader.
How long have you been down here?
Since the before times.
About a month, actually. We were building an extension on this line, but we got lost, so we figured we'd better establish a new civilization.
Wow, you established a new civilization in a month?
You'd be surprised how much you can get done when you're not constantly setting up and moving orange cones.
I shall be the leader!
Seriously, Scott.
So, you've got agriculture, art, rudimentary government.
Licorice somehow? You're actually going to eat that?
I'm trying to distract myself from the walls moving in on us. Wonder what part of the chicken this is.
The rat part.
Granola bars?
Oh, he bears the sweet manna of the Overland.
Oh, no thanks. I just had some chicken and kind of lost my appetite.
Yoji, what are you doing here?
Please be rescuing us.
The floppy-eared one shall be our leader.
Weren't you allergic to dogs?
Oh,
right. You know what? Yeah, I actually am.
I'm over here.
You're slimmer than I remember.
It's the physique that I was cursed with.
I'll admit that I'm confused you're not the one that I rehearsed with. I think we've gone off book now. I believe this scene we're botching.
But I feel we should go on because there's all these people watching.
So I guess that you're a baritone and now we have to fight. I'm a mezzo-soprano and it all ends tonight.
Actually, you sing between a tenor and a bass, and that makes you a baritone. Your hostility's misplaced.
Say what?
Mezzo-soprano is your family name, but you all sing in baritone. That makes you all the same.
Wait a minute. Mezzo-soprano is a family name, but we all sing in baritone. That makes us all the same. You're right.
Mezzo-soprano is a family name, but we all sing in baritone. That makes us all the same. We are all baritones.
You know, every time a masked bandit comes furiously charging towards me, I like to take a deep breath. Ah! Whoa! Whoa!
Whoa! Whoa! Whoa! Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
Stop! It's a good thing I had this lacrosse stick.
What is a masked bandit even doing on a dude ranch?
Well, he can't get away with that at the outlet mall.
Hey, I'm Jackie. I pull that with all our guests. Did I get your hearts racing?
Yes, indeed.
Sure did.
A little.
That's how I like it. After all, I am the great-great-great-great-great-granddaughter of Calamity Jane.
Really? I'm the great-great-great-great-grandson of the original Murphy, of Murphy's Law.
Never heard of it.
Really?
Yeah, I make a point of not knowing any laws.
Well, it just means that anything that can go wrong will go wrong. Around me.
Awesome. Do you guys want my version of the tour?
Well, I don't know. The two of us together?
Yeah, we already hit our danger quota, right, Zach?
I wasn't saying that. Why would I say that? I love danger. Danger is in my blood. It's my fuel. Danger is my middle name. Well, it's Milo's middle name, but it could be my middle name. I could change it.
I'm afraid we've lost him.
Everybody go before we left?
You bet, Dad.
Excellent, son. Whoa, we don't have a son.
Oh my gosh, this seat isn't a flotation device. Okay, I'll see you soon. We're gonna meet my family at Boulder City, Mr. Brulé.
How are you not freaking out right now?
Not my first rodeo.
Ooh, he's been to the rodeo?
How exotic.
Okay, Boulder City, then right back on track to the Grand Canyon.
Again.
I roll.
Charlene, Sharon, Jar.
Come on, girls, it's your favorite canyon. It's everyone's favorite canyon.
It's certainly my favorite canyon.
It's just that we go every year.
Every year.
It's a lot of canyon.
And it's going to be grand.
Jar.
Come on, gang. The canyon's waiting impatiently for our arrival.
Jar.
And on your left, you can see... Nope, you missed it. And back there was... There it was. It's gone now. Oh, and there's Lard World with Lardy Boy out front, sharing his signature brand of enthusiasm.
Lardy Boy? Cool.
You're so calm. He's so calm.
Are all your vacations like this?
Well, not exactly like this, but reminiscent. Like when we got stuck in a shark cage?
Stop it.
In the Andes?
Shut up.
During a tidal wave?
He's so dangerous. In a sweater vest.
We've never had our own action sequence before.
Best vacation ever.
Thank you for looking after Milo. I am so sorry.
That was thrilling. Who knew vacations could be so exciting?
I guess Milo showed us there's more to vacations than the Grand Canyon.
Hello, hello, hello. Ye old pizza. Milo? I don't believe it. Is that you?
Veronica? How long have you been a pizza squire? I haven't seen you in like 300 fortnights.
I know, right?
Put the calculator down.
It's been a long time. How are you? How's Yuji?
Veronica who? I thought we knew all his friends.
I thought we were all his friends.
Should I bring your favorite pepperoni and sausage?
Make it a large and you can join us.
And a diet soda.
Hey!
Chop, 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 chop away at...
I want a girl with a suit of armor. A chainmail, she's a real Renaissance charmer. She's not the kind of girl who is easily rattled. She knows her way around the broadsword battle. I want a girl with a suit of armor now.
Guys, she's getting close. I can feel it.
Milo, I'm coming in hot.
Battle stations, everyone. Melissa, fire extinguisher. Zach, trampoline. Ready?
Ready.
Ready.
One 1,000th of a fortnight.
And it's not even on fire.
Oop, spoke too soon. But none the worse for wear. Everybody, this is Veronica. Veronica, these are my other two friends.
Hello.
Okay, so how do you guys know each other?
Veronica was my last babysitter.
Last babysitter standing.
Oh.
She was the only one smart enough and resourceful enough for the job. She had a backpack that just happened to have exactly what we needed to fix any disaster. Murphy's Law is strong, but she was stronger. Because of that backpack.
And that's her backpack.
That's right.
He earned it. I better go back and get that drink. I had to use your diet soda and some mints to improvise an afterburner.
Don't make that trip again on my account.
Oh, no, it's my pleasure. I was a huge fan of the Lumberjacks. Gotta go. Chop, chop, chop. Mwah. I'll be back with a soda in a few.
Good morning, students. I'm Miss Baxter, your substitute teacher. But can I really call myself a teacher? Will I be able to teach you anything in this brief interval where our lives overlap? And if I did, how would I ever know?
Oh, I forgot the third one, the discouraged burnout.
Nice likeness.
Thanks.
Today I'll show you this moderately accurate movie about exothermic reactions.
Excuse me, Ms. Baxter? Our school doesn't have the most up-to-date audiovisual equipment.
Do you have anything that'll play on this? It's called a zoetrope. We also have a horse jumping and one of a fish.
And no one can figure out what this one is.
Well, I guess that means I'll have to teach. You there, boy with the kind eyes. You're my teacher's aide for the day.
Cool! These glasses really work.
Young lady, just because you have a substitute doesn't mean you can text during class.
That's not my phone. That just made a weird noise.
How do you turn this thing off?
Substitute science teacher in space. Can you teach them in the brief interval where your lives overlap? How will you ever know? How will you ever know? Science teacher in space.
Miss Baxter, your hair's a little messed up.
Really? That's what jumped out at you about that whole thing?
You're in charge.
So, is this another house with a weird shrine to Milo?
It's the home of Orton Malson, creator of the Doctor's Own files. He actually retired here a few months ago and became a bit of a recluse. Maybe he can tell us how Milo was in that 1965 pilot episode. DOG Ex Machina Murphy, you get home this instant!
That's weird. He always goes home when you... Wait, his middle name is Ex Machina?
Never mind that. The creator of your favorite show of all time lives across town from you? And this is the first time you've ever been here?
Yeah. Today. I usually just stare from behind that tree.
Oh, please go away! I don't give autographs and I don't take shelfies or whatever it is you kids call them.
No, Mr. Malson, we aren't here for that. Of course, if you're offering, no, this is an emergency.
Oh, all right.
Whoa, you look like a really old Dr. Zone.
Yeah, that was totally worth opening the door for. Thanks, kid.
Sorry, I mean, I didn't know you were the show's creator and the star.
Sarah, you knew this?
Of course, who doesn't know that?
Newbies.
And then we found these two weird guys in a bunch of our friends' pictures. Show them, Melissa. Here.
Let's see now. Ooh, Cavendish and Dakota.
Yes, yes, very strange, pistachio-obsessed fellows. It was them that gave me the inspiration for Dr. Zone and Time Ape.
And what about our friend Milo?
Oh, yes, of course. They had their young ward with them. Oh, and now that I think about it, he left me something. He said that in 50 years, someone might ask about him. And I was to give them this letter.
All the hairs on the back of my neck just stood up. And I shave my neck every day.
This letter could be... Wait, you shave your neck every day?
It's from Milo, dated 50 years ago.
What does it say?
Meet me at school with my backpack at 3 p.m. on... Wait, that's today's date.
And less than 15 minutes from now.
Oh, don't forget this.
Thanks! I am not worthy!
Oh, I hope I haven't told them too much. Or too little. Oh, I don't know. Shelfie! Oh, I'm posting that.
Where am I?
You've been in a coma. For 12 years.
Hooray!
In a world where krill are everywhere.
They're very, very small, but they're everywhere.
One man has what it takes to fight back.
Give up, krill hunter. They're everywhere.
I'll catch you on the flip side.
Yeah! Oh, I get it. It's sarcasm.
Actually, it's a pun.
From the visionary minds that brought you Krill Hunter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13.
I'll get you, Krill!
Hey, you got him! I think.
Starring Tobias Trollhammer.
I'm not the krill hunter I used to be.
Gretchen Flamkuchen.
Oh, krill hunter, I'd love to go swimming.
I wouldn't advise it.
And Sherwin Dusterwinkle as Professor Grant.
Krill joy.
Krill Hunter 14. Krill or be krilled.
I'm gonna need some humpback up.
And that's why Tobias Trollhammer is my idol.
This script is awful. No stunts, no action, and there's hardly any krill in it at all. No wonder my fans have abandoned me.
Your fans haven't abandoned you. In fact, I saw a whole line of them out there. As soon as they get their ice cream, they're going to come over here, Tobias.
It's almost like my career has been jinxed by a Menenkainen.
What the heck is a Menenkainen?
It's a goblin from Scandinavian folklore. He comes on his leather doomed to curse you with bad luck and eat your soul.
How does he eat your soul?
I do not know the particulars.
Tobias, I promise you, there's no goblins hunting you.
You say that, but you do not know.
Okay, places, everyone. Let's try to get this in one take. Tobias, remember now, you've spent days hunting krill to save the little girl in the hospital.
Oh, they're filming right over here.
Action!
I don't see any krill on the horizon. I think everything's gonna be all...
What's wrong with him?
He's acting. Keep rolling.
I'm here to eat your soul!
Ladies and gentlemen, Victor Belizer!
Thank you. Thank you. Ever since the 1950s, we've been promised one thing.
Robots! Am I right?
Yeah! No, I wanted flying cars!
And has anyone ever made good on that imagined promise?
Actually, the Japanese have had robots.
No!
Until today. I present to you an invention that will change everything forever. The Cybernetic Individual Domestic Droid, or SID.
Hello, Dr. Verleeser. Hello, everyone. I am Sid.
Hi, Sid!
I just flew in from Silicon Valley, and boy, are my servos tired.
Isn't he fantastic? Sid is going to revolutionize your life. How often have you tried to peel a hard-boiled egg, only to get those little pieces of eggshell stuck under your fingernails?
Nope, never happened
to me. I don't have a problem with that. Sid?
He solved a problem I didn't even know I had.
But wait, there's more.
You there, in the sweater vest and slippers.
Come on up here. Oh, yeah, right up here.
Safety goggles
way ahead of you.
What do you like more than anything?
My family?
Card tricks, of course.
Pick a card, any card. Ow. I am so sorry, young man. I hope I did not hurt you.
You're a very polite robot, Sid.
I try.
Not to worry. Sid is well-equipped for the unexpected.
Ow.
You see? Sid can't be knocked down.
Ow.
And he's so advanced, he actually feels pain while I hit him.
Ow.
And he can multitask. He can juggle, do your taxes, and make a perfect souffle.
Do you have any business expenses you'd like to deduct?
Gosh, no, but I do love souffles. Where did you learn how to do all this cool stuff?
From... Zero. Must find zero. Zero.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sid is just a prototype, and we're still working out a few of the kinks. That's the end of our presentation. Goodbye.
Wait. Didn't Victor Verleeser used to work with a partner?
Yes. Clyde Rickenbacker. It was a big story when they broke up.
What if? And just go with me on this. What if Clyde is 00?
You're saying the man who invented the V-neck sweater took credit for someone else's work?
Well, there's one way to find out. Find Clyde Rickenbacker.
Did it. He's right over there. Boo!
How did you do that?
He just posted a selfie, and we're in the background.
I'm a good inventor, but I'm a terrible businessman. I just don't know the value of a dollar. This is like 63 cents, right?
It's 100 pennies! How many times do we have to have this conversation?
Did I hear 150 years in the future?
Oh, hello, Sheriff. Murphy, is it? Oh, funny, as in Murphy's Law.
Well, I am a Murphy, and I am the law.
I reckon you are. You hear that? I said reckon. Reckon you are. Whoa, look at that. Good thing it's not Sunday.
New clothes, eh? Philip here is the best tailor in these here parts. Of course, he's the only one. If y'all from the future, I reckon that means you're time travelers. We get a lot of those down here.
You do?
They hang out at the So-So Corral, best saloon in these here parts. Of course, it's also the only one. Place is just down the street. This street, that is. The only street!
The only person I know personally who's really from here is Sheriff Murphy, personally.
Sheriff Murphy, that's it. He's a Murphy, and he's the law. He is...
the original Murphy's Law.
You're a real conclusion stealer, you know that?
So, how long have you been a Dr. Zone fan?
Well, the truth is my dad used to watch it when I was in fourth grade, and I got to the point where I would run downstairs every time I heard the theme song, and then I wouldn't want to watch anything else, and then I watched every episode until I could write it down from memory, and then I asked my mom if I could change my name to Time Ape, and she said no.
That is really weird. I think I need to go. I'll see you around the comic shop, a place where I work, but in which I am not at all personally invested.
No, no, no!
No what?
No mustard?
If you feel that strongly about it. I like that you have strong feelings about things.
You do?
Yeah, not many of my friends have that quality.
Oh, we're friends. Not a date.
And that's why I didn't think Time Ape was Dr. Zone's brother.
People don't talk about Time Ape on dates.
It was your theory about the chromium gazebinate that convinced me. It was brilliant.
Compliment. 1 point for date.
Ooh, excuse me.
Not date. Date! Not date. Date! Not date. Don't worry, he can't see us.
So I was thinking we could go to that cool downtown comic shop. It has all the same comics, but they're arranged more interestingly.
Date! Friend! Date! Arranged more interestingly? Who says that to someone they're interested in?
Or not?
Let's go!
Isn't this place interestingly laid out?
Mm-hmm.
Sarah, do you not like comics anymore?
No. Yes. I know I've been weird today. I've been a little in my head about it.
I know what you mean. Sometimes it's like there are these cosplaying versions of myself in my head debating, and I have to be like, shut up, Turgenite Alien Neil! Or shut up, Out Loud Neil.
And check. I guess it was a to-do list. Sorry about that.
Are you kidding? That was the best first date ever. It was a date, right?
Hi, cuz.
Hey, Milo.
This is my cousin, Nate. He's in denial about the whole Murphy's Law thing.
I'm not in denial. I just don't have it. It skipped a generation.
Right. So, I'm sure your luggage will be here.
Yeah, it's not here. There it is, the green one.
Hey, over here!
All right, yes, sir.
We are about to take off. You need to take your seats.
My bag!
Better call Sarah.
You might want to go to long-term parking. We're at 30,000 feet.
Yeah, okay.
Murphy's Law, huh?
Yeah, I don't have Murphy's Law.
Ooh, I can't wait to see Grandma and Grandpa.
Yeah, grandparents are the best. Hey, are yours full of great stories and wise advice?
They might be. There's no way of telling.
How come?
You'll see.
Hey, Grandma and Grandpa!
Well, hey, hello!
Kids, we
look
had the nicest ride here, Grandpa.
Looks like we're the last ones off the train.
Now we're late.
I get hungry, but now we're ready to go.
Let us help you with those bags.
Dice?
Locked. I'll go talk to the conductor.
Well, I think
I would
we
suggest
should pull
trying
the
to break this window
over
here.
There,
but
that's
quite
the thing
thick.
To do, Grandpa.
Would you agree?
Good suggestions, from what I heard.
Wait.
Hey, Sarah. We're gonna be a few minutes.
Yeah, I got it.
Now, I haven't seen Murphy's Law so strong since...
1965 or 4.
I don't have it.
You should be proud to be a Murphy, son. Do you know anyone else who spends the holidays climbing across the roof of moving trains or sinking into iceberg-infested waters?
No.
I think my toes might fall off. And that's great because I have the worst toes.
Hi, honey! Did he tell you it skipped a generation in our family?
He did.
Oh, isn't that adorable?
I don't have it.